So let's take a look at what happens when you quit an app. Now I've got a couple apps open here, and the first one is Preview, and I have a PDF document open in Preview. Now I can quit using Command Q or go to Preview, Quit Preview. Same thing either way. When I do that and then I run Preview again, what happens is the document I was looking at will just simply open again to the same position, and if I have multiple documents open, all of them will open again. Now I'm going to hide that and look here, and I've got Safari, and I actually have two windows open in Safari. I've got this one window with a Wikipedia article, and I have another window here that actually has two tabs in it. So I'm going to quit Safari. And when I reopen Safari, look what happens. I get both of those windows open and all the tabs in all those windows open again. So this is normal behavior. But you can choose to actually close all of the windows for these apps if you want. So for instance, in Preview here, I could of course just close the window, hit the red X there, and that would close that window, close that document, and then I could quit Preview. I could also go to Preview and hold the Option key down on my keyboard, and you could see it changes from Quit to Quit and Close All Windows. So I can select that, and now when I launch Preview again, it doesn't open up that document. Matter of fact, it goes to the default kind of select a document thing. The same thing here with Safari. I go Safari, quit Safari, hold the Option key down, and you can see it changes to quit and close all windows. Now, if you prefer to always close all windows when you quit, you can do that. Go to System Preferences, and under System Preferences, click on General. And there's an option here called Close Windows When Quitting App. If you check that, then go back to Safari, quit Safari will work in that everything is closed, and now when I run Safari again, and this is the same for Preview and everything else, it starts fresh. All those windows are gone. Now notice when I do that, if I hold the Option key down, quit Safari changes to quit and keep windows. So Option Command Q is the opposite. You can either keep quit and close all windows if you have it set one way, or quit and keep windows when you have it set the other way. So you always have the opportunity to do the opposite of what you have it set for in System Preferences by holding the Option key when using Command Q or selecting the application and the quit function. Now let's say that you quit an app, I quit Preview here, and I have it set so that it's not going to close windows when quitting apps. So now when I launch Preview again, I have no choice. It's going to bring up the documents that were open before. But there is a way to get around that. If you've got the app in the dock, in this case I moved Preview to the dock, then you can hold the Shift key down and launch. And let's say I won't hold the Shift key down here. I'll launch, and you can see it brings back that document. But if I hold the Shift key down and launch, it will not do it. It will launch clean. The same thing is true with Safari. If I click on Safari and then I go to a site, I quit, I launch Safari again, you can see it's going to return to that site. So let me quit again, and now I'm going to Shift and launch Safari. Then it will close all the windows. So you can kind of do it retroactively when you launch the app the next time by simply holding the Shift key down. That only really works, I believe, if the app is in the dock, or if you're launching it from the Applications folder. It doesn't seem to work if you're doing a Spotlight search and trying to launch that way.